Hi guys! Today, let's talk about problem resolution management in Automotive SPICE. I'll explain the three most important points you need to consider to set up a proper problem resolution management process. My name is Klaus Hormann, and I'm a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. I have more than 20 years of experience in assessments and trainings. My colleagues and I have done many hundreds of assessments and trainings since we started Kugler Maag in 2004. Our business is to help our clients to implement Automotive SPICE and thus achieve business value. In our channel, we share knowledge about Automotive SPICE and process improvement. All right, let's get started. Why does problem resolution management really matter? In a project, there are many problems that you have to take care of. For example, the customer reported a serious malfunction in the software that was delivered last week. You need someone to check what the cause is, fix it, and then deliver a corrected version. This sequence involves many people and many different steps. Many things can go wrong on this way. It is very likely that the customer will not receive his solution and he will be disappointed. And that's why you need problem resolution management. You need to reliably manage this process and to ensure that all work steps are completed on time and that the solution is ready at the desired time. Our point number one is a great problem resolution management strategy. Solving a problem requires dozens of people in different teams and locations. If you don't coordinate these people and track the status of problems as they flow through the different steps, it will never work. A good strategy makes it clear to all involved how the workflow is, how progress is controlled, and who is responsible for what. Sounds simple, but to be honest, in most of my assessments, there is no clear strategy. Here is your solution for the contents of a great strategy. Number one, define the categories of problems you want to address, such as internal problems, customer problems, process problems, technical problems, software problems, hardware problems, organizational problems, and so on. Number two, define who can submit problem tickets. Number three, define the tools to be used for the categories. Number four, define the status that tickets can have during processing. Number five, define how and by whom progress will be tracked. This will help all people to do the right thing. That is what counts. Let's come to point number two, urgent resolution actions. Let me give you a typical example. The customer performs integration tests in the field. Your device does not interact correctly with other devices, blocking the entire test process. He calls someone in your company and wants a solution now. The problem is that your problem resolution process involves many steps and takes a lot of time, much more time than the customer expects. Well, how do you deal with it? And here's your solution. Within your strategy, you have a definition of how to deal with such situations. This includes an accelerated process, for example, skipping some of the tests normally required. This, of course, involves some risks. Therefore, you also need to define who can authorize these types of shortcuts. Finally, you must specify how the process steps you have skipped are to meet up after the end of the urgent resolution case. With these simple steps, you can save valuable time, make customers happy, and still do everything your process require. Also, don't forget to train the people involved properly. Point number three is solving the problems. Well, solving the problems sounds like a piece of cake. In fact, this is not the case, and I've seen many disasters. For example, problem management is out of control because nobody is in charge. Problems get lost or stuck or are solved far too late. And the worst thing is that the developers don't have enough time to solve problems when a large number of problems come in. Now let's talk about solutions, and let me present some best practices and experiences. In the strategy, you should have a status model of the problems. For example, new in evaluation, in implementation, implementation completed, released, delivered, approved by customer. When developers perform the problem resolution process, they switch the status in their task management tool to the next status. Also, make sure that you have someone who actively monitors the flow of the problems. This person should regularly create status reports or dashboards. These reports are evaluated in weekly technical sessions where issues are discussed and solutions agreed. Make sure that developers are not 100% busy developing new features and have enough time to resolve problems. Therefore, if you know when a large number of new issues will come up, make sure the developers have enough time left. If you keep all this in mind, your problem management will simply work great. Well, this was a summary of problem resolution management. If you follow these points, you will implement powerful problem management functionality, keep control of your problem management, and you will avoid having disappointed customers. If you need more information, we have a white paper on problem resolution management that you can download from our website. You can find the link in the description below. And take a look at our other Automotive SPICE videos. If you want to learn more about Automotive SPICE, subscribe to this channel. And don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. Finally, thanks for watching, good luck and goodbye.